was amazing. Getting to talk on stage with industry experts, industry leaders, CEOs, is really quite like a pinch me moment where I'm just a big fan of gaming and of esports, and to be able to share a stage and share my opinion with such like groundbreaking and industry leading people in their field, and yeah, amazing. Gaming has been such a big part of my life and is still a part of my life, and it will be until I die. I have been gaming for as long as I can remember. My first memories were of the GameCube, playing Mario Kart on that, a bit of Zelda, and it's just always been something which I've carried on through my life, where it's a place for me to escape to, especially with my sport, where things can get really hectic and physically demanding, mentally demanding as well. Being able to jump into a video game and kind of just be a different person for a little bit. It sounds a little bit corny, a little bit cheesy, but I think it's a really healthy place for me to escape to. I see the sport, I see the link between sport and gaming as just another arena which people can compete in, can participate, can find their place in the world, because I've been fortunate enough to find my place in swimming. I'm a marathon swimmer. I swam for Team GB at the Olympic Games, and I've been very fortunate to discover that. But not everyone might not get that opportunity to discover what their sport may be. But gaming is so broad and so vast and fairly reliable in accessibility, whether it's a game on your phone or you're fortunate enough to have a console or a PC. So I think the link is just fostering a healthy competitive environment for people to thrive in. Go for it. I'd say if you're a sports federation and you're interested in esports, you think there's a synergy between yourself and an esport, reach out, try and have those conversations. As I was saying on stage, the main thing that esports has, which I don't think traditional sports have, is they're not afraid to fail. They really just get in, see what happens, give it a try. If it fails, okay, we've learned from that. What can we do better next time? And I think traditional sports could do like really well and further their scope in taking that mentality on board a little bit and just trying something new. You know, everything has to be tried at some point, I think. And, you know, a sport wouldn't have developed into what it is today if the rules weren't changed at some point or something like that. You know, if you look back at the very first forms of football, it's a very different game from what it is now. So I just think trying something new you'll either learn from it and fail, or it'll succeed and everyone will be like, wow, I can't believe we didn't think of this before. I've loved it. I've loved being at SportAccord. It's amazing. There's so many amazing people in the room. Like, I know it's like quite obvious, but from someone who's kind of just getting started in this kind of career, you know, having a career outside of my elite sport, getting to talk to such amazing people who are interested in my story, and I'd love to learn from their wealth of experience. So it's been an honor. Thank you.